Hey there, it's Etan, and I'm standing in front of one of the most important financial institutions in East Los Angeles history. So this used to be the Pan American Bank. And starting in 1966, when it opened, it served a largely Chicano population. These were folks that came in largely after World War II and set down roots, and not a lot of other lenders would give them the time of day. Their wages tended to be lower, their credit might not be great, and they had lower rates of employment and lower rates of home ownership. There weren't a lot of banks that would talk to the Chicano community, but Pan American Bank stepped in and did just that. They were the first bank in California that had a staff entirely made up of bilingual English and Spanish speakers. And from 1966 until they were acquired by Beneficial, just a few years ago, they served this community and really helped this community thrive by giving out personal loans and business loans, small business loans, to small mom and pop businesses. So very important. Now the origin story of Pan American Bank is pretty fascinating too. There is a woman named Romana Acosta Banuelos, and she was a successful entrepreneur in the area. By the 60s, she had the most successful Mexican food wholesale vendor in the country. And she was instrumental in getting the Pan American Bank's charter and investing some of the early money that helped it start up. She would be on the board of the bank for a few years at the end of the 60s, and then in 1971, she was tapped by Richard Nixon to be the first Latina treasurer of the United States. She held that position, I believe, until 1974 when she resigned, and then came right back to the bank. This bank is also significant historically because of the mural that you see under those five arches on the facade. So this mural was designed by a Mexican artist named José Reyes Meza and installed by a famous mosaic studio called Byzantine Studios out of Cuernavaca, Mexico. They also had headquarters in San Francisco. Now, what made this mural different is that it depicted scenes from Mexico's history from before Europeans arrived. There are a lot of pre-Columbian Aztec gods and motifs that you would see from the art from hundreds of years ago in Mexico before the Spanish arrived. And you'll also see on the panel on the left of the facade a depiction of an Aztec warrior fighting a Spanish conquistador. So this was a very influential mural. It also had a big impact on the art community. Right across the street, there is another store, the First Street store, that is decorated with murals that were inspired by the one on the Pan American Bank. It was created about 10 years after the fact. And of course, the architecture of this bank is pretty cool. It was designed by Raymond Stockdale in what they call the New Formalism style. Basically taking some of the elements of classical Roman and Greek architecture, like arches, columns, colonnades, and sort of making it more sleek and modern. So those arches are monumental, but they're also not stuffy. They don't have a lot of decorations on them. Very 50s and 60s looking building. Pan American Bank started falling on some hard times in the early 2000s. 2005 was the last year it was profitable. And it was bailed out in 2016 by a consortium of 17 other banks and lenders. And then the following year, it was acquired by Beneficial State Bank. And Beneficial is set up in a special legal way that it is accountable both to its shareholders, but also to its humanitarian and environmental goals. So it sounds like a lot of Pan American's original mission is being preserved in the mission of its new owner. Thanks for doing LA with me.